I'm Chip Smith. Welcome to a new video. We're at the Beehives right now, and the Queen wanted independence. It had American spirit, and it left. And what happens with the Beehive is if the Queen leaves, all the males follow her. Because for some reason, women are man's weakness. But it went over there, hid under a bush. We had to go spend about $200 on another hive. It's dangerous. It's exciting. We're going to get so much honey.
It was April 20th, roughly 7:41 p.m. The bees were found. They were gathered together, holding hands, gob after gob. One sting and I could land in the hospital. What do? I put the camera on it, get closer, put my nose on the bees. Right here, they're wobbed together. One sting and I could go to the hospital. Honey, the love for honey, the love I have is dear. Jimmy has a suit on, but all I had was long sleeves and pants. Nothing more, nothing less. The sound of these creatures put fear in your bones. But I, only I, had a camera that was deep enough to go into the wild, to observe these creatures without fear of getting stung or dying a horrible death. I understand that one sting and I could potentially pass away, but that does not scare me. Hopefully you enjoyed that last voiceover. I was going to delete it, but I mean, it's just too funny not to keep. But we had men working on the building behind the house, and they found these bees, and Jimmy, he just freaked out. He loves honeybees. He has a hive already, and part of the hive left, and they're starting a new colony right there. And Jimmy got his bee suit on, went and grabbed all the bees, and I was safe distance with the camera, at least 3 inches from the hive. So I didn't get stung once, but I had some land on my head, on my hands, and I'm very allergic, and if I went to the hospital, it would not have been good for me. The chances of getting that virus at the hospital are very high right now, and I don't want to go.
I mean, just look at that, boys. That is awesome. I mean, you can't see that anywhere else except the farm. It was an awesome day. After we got him transported, we walked him over and put him with the other nest and put it on cinder blocks to get it off the ground so ants and other animals would not go in after we put sugar water in. Now, Jimmy, he took cardboard. This is actually a smoker. He has wood pellets in the bottom of it, and he would not light to save the world. Almost blew us up with the lighter fluid. But he's burning cardboard right here, put it in the wood pellets. He's going to close that chamber, and we're going to make a good old smoker. But I did about blow us up. I dropped a flame right beside the bottle of lighter fluid, and I started laughing, and it could have been really bad. But we quickly blew it out. But right now, you want to get as much carbon dioxide to come out of that as possible. What this will do is make the bees go to the floor so they won't swarm out as soon as you open the lid. There's a little flap right there. You can smoke. Open the lid and smoke, and then smoke at the bottom. Try to get the bees calm and just let them go down in a way. It kind of makes them high. Get them relaxed, get them on the ground so they don't fly out and have a big swarm of bees attacking you. The part right here is so interesting. After you smoke them down, you have to put the rest of the beehive together. These are already pre-made, so the bees won't have to make these combs. They'll just lay honey inside the combs and it'll be easier to collect. You just pull it out and scoop the honey off once it's time for harvest. You can see how many bees are actually in there. There's close to 1,000. Now it's time to put the lid back on. We put sugar water in. We put all the hives in. Get a big old bungee cord tied together so they all don't lift up the lid at once and come and talk to us.
Through the whole thing, we didn't get stung one time. I'm severely allergic, and it was very awesome to do that, to separate the bees, to gather them, put them in the hive.